Welcome student to my YouTube channel Bharat Chem Study. Today we are going to study about the chapter solution for plus 2 class part 1. In this video we are going to study about the solutions, their types, method to express concentration like mass percentage, volume percentage, strength of solution, mole fraction, molarity, molality and some numerical based upon them. So let's start with the topic solutions. So it's a homogeneous mixture of two or more components in same or different phases whose composition may vary within certain limits. The types of solution, depending upon the total number of components present in the solution, they are classified as binary solutions, means made of two types of components, ternary solutions, means made of three types of components, quaternary solution, means made up of four components. In our study, we have to deal with the binary solution basically. So, binary solution consists of two components. First called solute. The component which get dissolved is called solute, or we can say the component which present in less quantity is called solute. The second component of binary solution is solvent. The component which dissolve other substance in itself are called solvent, or simply way, the component which is present in excess is called solvent. So the first definition was the exact definition of solute and solvent, but in this chapter we can identify solute and solvent by from their quantity. If it is present in less quantity, that means it is solute. If it present in excess quantity, that means it will be solvent. Note, abbreviation A is used for solvent and abbreviation B is used for solute. Whenever we are doing the numerical or we are writing the formula, we are using abbreviation A and B for solute and solvent. So please note this point also. Now the concentration of solution. It means the amount of solute present in a given quantity of solution. Method to express concentration of solutions are mass percentage or volume percentage, strength of solution, mole fraction, molarity, molality and normality. So in this chapter, 3 points are more important. First is mole fraction, second is molarity and third one is molality. These three are more important for us to do the numerical of this chapter, but we will study all one by one. So the mass percentage, also called weight by weight percentage or mass by mass percentage. So it is defined as the mass percentage of a component in a given solution is the mass of that component per 100 gram of solution. It is meant for total 100 gram of solution only. Mathematically, mass percentage of component A, we can call it solvent also, will be equal to the mass of that component, that is solvent, multiplied by 100 divided by the total mass of the compound or solution. Second, the mass percentage of B, and we know that B is used for solute, so that will be equal to the mass of component B, that is solute, multiplied by 100 divided by total mass of the compound or solution. Note that mass percent do not have any unit. Similarly, volume percentage can be written as the volume percentage of component A will be equal to volume of that component multiplied by 100 divided by total volume of the compound or solution. Mass percentage of component B, or we can say solute, is equal to volume of that component multiplied by 100 divided by total volume of compound or solution. Again, volume percentage also do not have any unit. So let's do one numerical based upon volume percentage or mass percentage. Most of the time in plus 2 class no numerical is coming, but some important points we have to learn from this, that's why we are doing one simple numerical. Calculate the mass percentage of benzene and carbon tetrachloride if 22 gram of benzene is dissolved in 122 gram of carbon tetrachloride. First of all, the mass of benzene is given 22 grams and mass of carbon tetrachloride, which is 122 gram. So because mass of benzene is less, that's why we take it as solute, and mass of carbon tetrachloride is more, that's why we are taking it as solvent. Total mass of the solution is 22 benzene plus 122 is equal to 144 gram. So the mass percentage of benzene can be calculated as mass of benzene multiplied by 100 divided by total mass of solution. So it will be equal to 22 into 100 divided by 144, and the answer come to be 15.28%. Now the mass percentage of CCl4, for that mass of CCl4 multiply by 100 divided by total mass of the solution, and on putting the value, the percentage come to be 84.72%. Because it consists of only two components, the mass percentage of CCl4 can also be calculated by subtracting 15.28 from 100, but that can be possible only when the solution is containing only two components. Note, if percentage by mass of substance in a solution is given, then it means that that much amount of substance is present in 100 gram of solution. So please understand this concept clearly. For example, if in a numerical it was given that 5% by mass of glucose is present, it means that the weight of glucose is 5 gram and the total weight of the solution will be 100 gram. That this interpretation we have to learn from the percentage. Non-numerical are basically coming to calculate percentage, but sometime for doing the other numerical, percentage by mass of the substance is given. So we have, from that we can interpret the mass of solute as well as the total mass of solution. That's why this line is more important. Now, number of moles. Moles of a solute is equal to NB. It can be represented by NB will be equal to mass of solute divided by the molar mass of the solute. Mathematically, it can be written as, in the form of abbreviation, that NB, which is called the moles of solute, equal to WB is the mass of solute divided by the molar mass of solute shown by capital MB. Similarly, moles of solvent, that is represented by NA, and A is abbreviation for solvent, that will be equal to mass of solvent divided by molar mass of solvent, and the formula in abbreviation can be written as that NA is equal to WA upon MA. It is written wrong here by mistake, WA divided by MA, where WA is the mass of the solvent and MA will be the mass of the molar mass of the solvent. WB is the mass of solute, MB is the molar mass of the solute, WA is the mass of solvent and MA is the mass of solvent. So here it is written by my mistake, it is written MB, but it will be coming here MA. Now, to study the mole fraction, that is having the symbol X, capital X, or X simply, it is defined as the ratio of the number of moles of one component to the total number of moles, that is the moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent present in the solution. Now, if we want to calculate the mole fraction of solute, that is represented by symbol XB, the formula will become equal to that the mole of solute divided by the moles of solute plus moles of solvent, that means the total number of moles present. Or it can be written as XB is equal to NB, which is the number of moles of solute, divided by NA plus NB, that is the total number of moles of solute, moles of solvent, as well as moles of solute. Similarly, to find the mole fraction of solvent, represented by formula XA, can be written as moles of solvent divided by moles of solute plus moles of solvent. So see that when we are going to calculate the mole fraction of solute, we have to take the moles of solute up in the numerator and total number of moles are always coming in the denominator. Similarly, when we have to cut the number of moles of solvent, then the moles of solvent must be taken in the numerator and in the denominator again coming the total number of moles of solute plus solvent. The formula of mole fraction of solvent XA is equal to NA divided by NA plus NB. So it's important to learn that how the mole fraction of solute and mole fraction of solvent can be calculated, because in our numerical related to this chapter, that can be important for us. Now, note, the sum of mole fraction of solute and solvent is always equal to 1. XA plus XB always equal to 1. Always remember this point. So, if we calculate any one of them, then the second can be calculated by subtracting the first value from the 1. For example, if we calculate the value of XA, XB can be calculated by subtracting XA value from 1. Since both denominator as well as numerators involve number of moles, therefore mole fraction do not have any unit. It's represented only a ratio. Now, molarity, also called as molar concentration, represented by capital M. It is defined as the number of moles of solute dissolved per liter of solution. Or molarity M can be represented by the formula that moles of solute divided by the volume of solution in liters. But if the solution is to be prepared in ml, in most of the time when we are doing the work in our chemistry lab, we usually prepare the solution in mls, because we are not going to make large amount of solution, we have to prepare only small amount of solution. So if the solution is to be made prepared in ml, then molarity can be written as moles of solute divided volume of solution in ml. So we have to multiply the moles of solute by 1000. Basically, we are putting this 1000 below ml so that the answer will be coming in liters. But because from this below, the 1000 is going above, so the formula become like this. So number of moles can be represented by NB for solute, multiply by 1000 and the volume of solution can be represented by the symbol V sol in ml. Now as moles of solute have the formula NB is equal to WB upon MB, so we can put this formula in the formula of molarity and we will get that molarity is equal to WB into 1000 divided by MB into volume of solution in ml. This is the final formula of molarity which we are going to use in our numerical. The unit of molarity is mole per liter. Because we are multiplying the upper side by 1000, that means the volume given in ml automatically get converted into liter. That's why the unit is also coming in mole per liter, where W is the mass of solute, MB is the molar mass of the solute, VSOL is volume of solution. Some important point. In some numerical, molarity is also written as molar concentration, or only capital M is written at the back of the value. For example, 2 molar or 2 capital M solution means that molarity of the solution is 2. That point we have to understand while giving the numerical. So we should interpret that this value is given for the molarity. It also means that if the molarity is 2, that means 2 moles of solute are present in 1 liter of solution. So by giving the value of molarity, we've been able to identify the total number of moles of solute present and the total volume of the solution also. So these can be useful for the numericals. Now molarity shown by small m, or it may be called as molal concentration. It is defined as the number of moles of solute dissolved per kilogram of solvent. Molarity have the formula moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kg. But if solvent is to be prepared in grams, then the molarity can be written as moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in gram. So to convert mass into kg, we have to divide this mass given in gram divided by 1000, and that 1000 will be going to the numerator, and the formula become the mass of solute into 1000 divided by mass of solvent in grams. Or mass of solute will be having the formula symbol NV, 1000 divided by WA, where WA in grams means the weight of solvent. And we know that the formula of moles of solute is equal to WB upon MB. So we put the formula in the formula of molality and we get the value that molality small m is equal to WB into 1000 divided by MB into WA in grams. And the unit of molality is mole per kg. So this was the final formula to calculate the molality. So that's why it's important to learn. So please note down the final formula of mole fraction, number of moles, molality and molarity, because these are most important which we are going to use in the next topics of numerical of these chapters. So where WB is the mass of solute, MB is the molar mass of solute, WA is the mass of solvent. Note, in some numericals, molality is written as molal concentration or only small m at the back of the value. For example, 2 molal or 2 m small solution means the molarity of the solution is 2. It also means that 2 moles of solute are present in 1 kg of solvent. So by knowing the value of molarity, we can identify the number of moles of solute present and the total weight of the solvent. So that will also be helpful in the numerical. So these points should be again learned. Now one numerical, calculate the molarity of the solution containing 10 gram of acetic acid. The formula of acetic acid given in 500 ml of solution. So in solution, the weight of solute, which is acetic acid, which is present in less amount, is given as 10 gram. The volume of solution is given as 500 ml. Now, molar mass of acetic acid can be calculated, which is coming to be 60. So putting the value in the formula, we get the answer as 0.33 mole per liter or m. So the answer of the molarity can be written in two ways. Either you can write mole per liter at the back, or you can write only capital M. Both mean that this is the value of molarity. So this type of numerical we have already done in our plus one class. So that's why I'm not giving too much stress on these numericals. One more numerical, calculate the molarity of the solution containing 10 gram of acetic acid in 100 gram of solvent. So here we have to calculate molarity. The weight of solute is given and the weight of solvent is given. Always remember, in case of molarity, we required volume of the solution, but in case of molality, we have required the weight of only solvent, not the solution. So weight of solute is given 10 gram, weight of solvent is 100 gram, and molar mass of acetic acid is come to be 60. So on putting the value in the formula of molality, we can find out the answer, which is coming 1.66 mole per kg or small m. So again, in case of molality also, you can write that unit of molality in two way. Either you will write mole per kg or you will write only small m at the back of the value. Both means that this is the value of molality. Now, few important points. Molality is the better way to express concentration as compared to molarity. Now, why? Because molality does not change with temperature, because molality involves weight of solvent and number of moles. Both do not vary with temperature. Whereas molarity involves volume of solution, which may vary with the condition of temperature or humidity. That's why we can say the molality is better way than the molarity to express the concentration. Now, second important point, a molar solution of a solute in water is more concentrated than a molar solution. That means the molarity solution is more concentrated than the molar solution. So why this happens? Because molar solution contain 1 mole of a solute in 1000 ml of water, while a molar solution contain 1 mole of solute in 1000 gram of water. Since the volume correspond to 100 gram of water would be more than 100 ml of water. So, मैं आपको हिंदी में समझा देता हूँ. तो 100 ग्राम अगर हम वाटर लें और उसको वॉल्यूम में कन्वर्ट करें तो वो 100 ml से ज्यादा आएगा. उसी तरह से अगर हम 1000 ग्राम वाटर को वॉल्यूम में कन्वर्ट करें तो उसकी वैल्यू 1000 ml वाटर से ज्यादा आएगी. यानी कि 1000 ग्राम वाटर जो होगा उसकी वैल्यू 1000 ml वाटर से ज्यादा आएगी. सो इसीलिए मोलैरिटी केस में क्या हो गया, वॉल्यूम ज्यादा हो गया, मोल्स कम हो गए तो उसकी कंसंट्रेट कम हो गई. लेकिन मोलर सॉल्यूशन में जो वॉल्यूम है वो 1000 ml में ही है, इसीलिए उसकी मोलैरिटी ज्यादा हो गई. दैट मींस इट्स मोर कंसंट्रेट. हेंस द वॉल्यूम ऑफ सॉल्वेंट कंटेनिंग 1 मोल ऑफ अ सॉल्यूट इज मोर इन केस ऑफ मोलर solution than molar solution. So the molar solution is more concentrated than molar solution. Please read it carefully, only then you will able to understand why this is going to be happen. Now, normality represented by capital N, it is defined as the number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved per liter of solution. Normality represented by capital N have the formula number of gram equivalent of solute. In this case, we are not calculating the moles of solute. We are calculating number of gram equivalent of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Again, if the solution is prepared in ml, then the normality can be written as gram equivalent of solute multiplied by 1000 divided by volume of solution in ml. So, now, but how we can calculate number of gram equivalent? The calculation number of gram equivalent or formula of number of gram equivalent is equal to mass of solute divided by equivalent mass of solute. So here new term come, equivalent mass of solute. Now the equivalent mass of a substance, basically in this chapter we are going to deal with acid and bases. That's why we are learning only to calculate the equivalent mass of acid and bases. So the equivalent mass of acid and bases can be calculated as the molar mass of solute divided by acidity or basicity of the acid or base. Now, basicity is the number of H positive ion an acid can give, and acidity is the number of OH negative ion a base can give. Or put in the formula of equivalent mass, number of gram equivalent can be written as mass of solute divided by molar mass of solute divided by acidity or basicity of base or acid. On rearranging, we get the formula, the number of gram equivalent is equal to mass of solute multiplied by acidity or basicity divided by molar mass of the solute. Now, as Wb is the mass of solute, Mb is the molar mass of the solute, V solution is the volume of solution. Therefore, number of gram equivalent will be have the formula Wb into acidity or basicity divided by Mb. Or putting the value in the formula of normality, we get the final formula of normality as normality N is equal to Wb into 1000 multiplied by acidity or basicity divided by Mb into volume of solution in ml. This is the final formula for normality. Unit of normality is gram equivalent per liter. Now the relationship between normality and molarity. The normality have the formula Wb into 1000 multiplied by acidity or basicity divided by Mb into volume of solution ml. And the formula for the molarity is Wb into 1000 divided by Mb into volume of solution. While seeing the formula of normality, these values 1, 2, 3, 4, these match with the formula of molarity. So that's why I'm just marking its color. So those values whose color is changing, these are the values of molarity. So instead of these value, we can put the molarity. So the formula of normality become, the normality is equal to molarity, that is capital M, into acidity or basicity. So study the definition, formula and unit of mole fraction, molality. Molarity most important in this chapter. In next video, we will study Henry law, vapor pressure, Raoult's law, for volatile and non-volatile solutes. Please like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.